3. So we have 1 over negative 3. Next, for coordinates C equals 0, negative 3, and D equals 7, negative 1. Hence, the gradient of CD, same formula, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So in this case, y2 is negative 1 minus negative 3, and 7 minus 0. So the numerator will be negative 1 plus 3 equals 2, and the denominator will be 7. So the gradient of CD is equals to 2 over 7. For example C, where E equals to negative 6, 6, and F equals 1, 6, hence the gradient of EF is given by y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So in this case, y2 is 6 minus 6 over 1 minus negative 6 here. Okay? So we have 0 over 7, which will be equals to 0. Okay, let's move on to the next topic, sketching of graph. In this case, the linear graph. So in order to sketch a straight line, we need to do two steps. The first step is to find the intercepts of x and y axis. Right? We need to find where does the straight line intercept with the x axis and y axis. And then step two, we will draw a line that passes through these two intercepts. Example three. Draw the following straight lines. Okay? So in order to draw the line y equals 2x minus 1. Alright? So first step is to find the intercepts of y axis. So if the intercept of y axis will be when x is equals to 0. So we substitute x equals 0 into the equation y equals to 2x minus 1. So when x is equals to 0, then y will be 2 times 0 minus 1, which will give us negative 1. So the intercepts of y will be equals to negative 1. So to find the intercept of x axis, the condition is y must be equals to 0. So when y is equal to 0, then we substitute into the equation, we will get 0 equals to 2x minus 1. Therefore, from here, shift the negative 1 to the left, so we will have 2x equals to 1, therefore x is equals to half. So next step is to mark the point negative 1, y equals to negative 1 here, and then x equals to half over here, and then join these two points, so you will get a straight line y equals to 2x minus 1. Okay, let's look at another example. If we are given y equals to negative 4x, then the intercepts of y axis will be, as usual, x equals 0. Substitute x equals 0 into the equation, we will get y equals 0. And to find another point, of course we cannot find the intercept of x axis here, because intercept of x axis will give us y equals 0. The answer will still be y0 at 0. So what we do in this case, we will take another value of x. Let's say x equals to 1. Substitute x equals to 1 into the equation. We will get y equals to negative 4. So from here, draw the x axis and y axis, and then mark the point y equals 0, which is here, and then mark the point y equals to negative 4. Yeah, when x equals to 1. So we have 1 and then y negative 4. So mark it here. So next step is to join these two points. Okay? Next example. If 2y plus 3x equals to 6, the intercept of y axis will be when x equals 0. Substitute x equals 0 into this equation. So we will get 2y plus 0 equals to 6. Then y will be equals to 3. And then to find the intercept of x axis, then you substitute y equals 0 into the equation just now. So from here, when y is equals to 0, then substitute into the equation, we will get 3x equals to 6. Therefore, x will be equals to 2. Then, as usual, draw the x-axis and y-axis. Mark the point y equals 3 on the y-axis, and then x equals 2 on the x-axis. So draw a line that passes through